Hi, I'm Chase Sharkey with Sharkey Mechanical. Our team of experts handle some of the largest and most complex air conditioning systems in the state. Give us a call today and let us attack your air conditioning needs. 225-222-3332.
Wow, you can do a double take as to where we are with school board member Brett Duncan. The buildings that used to be Southwood Academy, they were Harvest School, and more recently Tangi Academy. But the Tangipahoa School Board now has plans to buy this 17-acre campus, and therein hangs a tale. Brett, you almost have to see it to believe it.
Yeah, well, I'm glad we did get to come out and take a look at it, Ken. It's the campus is in great condition. I think it can help solve a lot of problems that are issues that we have as a school system, and actually free up some money to do some other projects throughout the parish.
Well, one thing that you're able to do is to get an offer on this building far below appraised value and infinitely below the cost of replacing it.
Right, and the last tenants of this building have done a lot of excellent work to it. So we would have some things that we would need to do to it before we could use it. But at the end of the day, we know that if we were to try to build a campus that could house this many students, it would cost us over $16 million. And the reason we know that is because we recently built a campus that housed roughly the same number of students up in O.W. Dillon, and that's how much it cost us.
And this will come in at about $4.2
million? Right. It'd be $4.2 million is what we're looking at for the purchase price, and then we have some additional dollars that we're looking at budgeting for some renovations.
Beyond the classroom space, maybe 25, 28 classrooms in that ballpark, you get a gym. And a substantial gym.
Right, sure, a gym. We have an administrative building, a cafeteria, a library building, and then, of course, the multiple classrooms and some property for some athletic fields.
What do you want to do with this building?
Well, so the main thing, you know, if we back up just a little bit, Ken, a few years ago we had our Vision 2020 Commission that came in and made some recommendations to the board and the administration, and specifically what they recommended to us was that we take a more strategic approach to the way that we spend dollars on facilities, along with a more strategic approach on retaining and hiring highly qualified teachers. So along those lines, we have brought in some experts that have told us or given us some advice on where we need to make sure that we're building to deal with demographic issues. And so this building will help us address some capacity issues that we already have and that we can anticipate being worse over on the east side of Hammond.
Well, specifically, it would have a big impact on Hammond East Side, which is incredibly overcrowded right now.
Correct. Hammond East Side is overcrowded, and the folks that we have studying this tell us that we're going to be even more overcrowded if we don't do something about it very, very soon. And so this building will help us to address that specific issue. And again, it will do it at a much lower price than any other options that may be available to us to address those capacity issues.
So the tentative plan would be that this will be kindergarten through second grade?
Well, we haven't committed to exactly how we will use this campus, but we do know that it will be used to address those specific capacity issues for students that live north of I-12 and on the east side of Hammond.
And it will be the Yokum Road School?
That's where it's located, is on Yokum Road in Hammond. What we will call it, how exactly it'll be used. Those are the things that we'll be looking at over the course of the next year. But I can assure folks that we're not looking at moving any kids here from Ponchatoula. We're not looking at any of other areas. This is for the purpose of addressing those capacity issues on the east side of Hammond.
Let me play devil's advocate with you. The reason that Hammond East Side is overcrowded is because everybody wants their kids to go there. Therein hangs a tale. Turning Hammond East Side into not just a magnet, but a very attractive magnet, it took years.
Right.
It took money. It took much labor and sweat equity.
Right.
What do you say to the parents who look at you and think, well, Brett, I know my kids will get a great education at Hammond East Side. This new school, who knows? Pig in the poke.
Well, I think that where we will end up, I am reasonably assured that what this campus will be is an extension of Hammond East Side's campus. What you will find here when it comes to programs, the IB program, the performing arts programs, all of those things that are offered at Hammond East Side we believe will be offered here as well.
So I want to be even a little more specific. There are a couple of millages that are specifically dedicated to schools like Hammond Eastside here in the 7th Ward. So will that money be shared with this campus?
Yep, absolutely. That's another beautiful part about where this campus is located and how we anticipate using it. You know, the bottom line, Ken, is that, yes, Hammond Eastside has become very attractive to parents in the Hammond area and beyond. The capacity there, we don't have enough room for everybody that wants to be there. But with this campus, we'll be able to offer that to more families.
Do you have reason to believe that when you add this physical facility, you know, build it and they will come, do you think that maybe the magnetic appeal, literally for a magnet school, might cause the total enrollment to grow some more and maybe alleviate overcrowding in some other areas?
Well, it could. I mean, we know that in the last few years, there have been about 200 students that have wanted to be able to attend Hammond Eastside that we have not been able to put there. And that's part of what we're trying to address with the purchase of this campus, along with all of those people who are moving into that area to try to get their student into Hammond Eastside and Hammond High School.
So how in the heck are you able to do this without a tax increase?
Well, so our administration has been able to find some creative financing options where I had mentioned earlier the O.W. Dillon campus. We have been budgeting about $1 million a year to pay the note on the O.W. Dillon campus, and that money is going to become available for us to do some additional things with. And so the administration has put together a package, and the purchase of this campus is the linchpin of that package, because again, the savings that we will get in addressing capacity issues with this purchase is freeing up additional dollars that we can use in the rest of the parish to address those capacity issues in the rest of the parish. But that's the way we're doing it. We're shuffling some money that we're currently spending in other areas. That money's going to be freed up, and then we'll be able to use those dollars to finance the purchase of this building and the rest of the package.
So you've complained before that the 7th Ward, the Hammond area, the Hammond School District, really, in your opinion, maybe it doesn't get all that you deserve here, that you pay a lot of the millage from the Hammond area, and by gum, you need the lion's share of the money. Do you think the purchase of this school campus, 17 acres, it's huge, and not just Eastside, but Hammond Westside's overcrowded as well, will this go a long way to telling the taxpayers in Hammond, look, we're giving you something big for your money?
Yeah, well, I hope it says that, and you're right. I have pointed out that, particularly when it comes to the sales tax portion of the funds that we receive as a school system, they come out of the Hammond area, and we ought to make sure that we're doing everything we can to make sure that the Hammond schools are taken care of for all sorts of reasons. But the other thing I hope that this demonstrates to the taxpayers is that we are trying to be as frugal with those tax dollars as we possibly can, where we can find a place or a way to do what we need to do and save money. We're going to try to do that. And that's what this does. This is a campus that is in good condition, that can accomplish what we need it to accomplish, and we're going to get it at a bargain. Which again, you know, the beautiful part of that is we have so many needs throughout our parish when it comes to facility needs. And so the ability to address a lot of those needs in one package is a great thing.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, I mean, we can talk about the other portions of the phase one package. This is all going to be on our capital outlay committee agenda this coming up Tuesday. Again, with the savings that we're going to have here, we have a major project at Ponchatoula High School that we're looking at, a major project at DC Reeves that we're looking to move forward on. At Hammond High School, we have another major project, which, can you believe, Ken, 10 years ago that Hammond High School only had 900 students attending there. We're now approaching, I believe, 1,800, which is a great success story. We're also looking at a project in LaRonja, which is long overdue. We haven't been able to do something in LaRonja in quite some time. So we're all excited about getting that done. And then a project in Kentwood, where we're trying to protect a very historic building in our parish by getting some work done over there. I don't think I left any major projects out, but you know, it's exciting for me as a board member that's been on the board for a number of years that we're able to move forward on such an important stuff, because we haven't been able to do that in quite some time.
Amwaste is the only full-service garbage disposal company in Tangipahoa Parish, offering from residential pickup to commercial pickup to construction, as well as heavy industrial disposal. At Amwaste, we pride ourselves in great service and competitive pricing. So let Amwaste be your waste provider, because at Amwaste, we care about our customers. Call today.